for this opportunity. I tried to sign up for all kinds of websites and couldn't, so I got my opportunity.
Yay. Yay.
So, the accent is South Africa, for those of you that don't know, just in case. And I do say ranch, not ranch. And that's the one that makes people go blind. It's like, what? Ranch? Anyway, I have been a person who wrote TMOL all over every notebook my whole life. Going back to 10, 11 years old, I've got TMOL written in little margins and corners. It's the meaning of life. And it's something that has been an intense passion for me for many, many years. I wrote last week in my blog about seeing these two pictures that were seared into my mind on what is going on here. What is at back of this? One was an old Arizona highways photograph of a withered, sparse old tree with a few little leaves wedged between some rocks, but it was ancient. You could see it was 50, maybe 150, maybe 300 years old. It had clung to life. The other one was a picture that had a family in the Balkans trundling behind a little homemade cart that was laden with their harvest for the year. And they were trundling off to market, and they were quite happy and pulling along. They were, you know, shabbily dressed in our communist countries of those times. And for me, there was the whole year wrapped up in that little cart. Everything. Whether they got shoes, whether they had food, whether they could survive the winter, was all wrapped up in that cart. And the same thing, it pulled at me really, really hard. Are they happy? Do they have meaning? What is meaning and purpose in life? And those two pictures still stand out. In my gut and my heart, I know what they mean. I know the answer, and the answer is absolutely yes. That life has meaning in all circumstances, at every moment. And if you're challenged at any moment, you can turn around and find the meaning. The meaning is inherent in your life and in the context of what is happening. So how do I come to apply that meaning in life to branding? For 30 years, I've worked in marketing and advertising. I ran an ad agency for a couple of years in South Africa until my partner paid his department store clothing account with the rent check. And I got scared. I had a three-month-old baby and a three-year-old. So I went back to work. Got another job, and of course, what did I do? Market research. Looking at brands, I think I went through all my resume and little lists and things. Over 500 brands, over 500 projects. So that's probably about 3,000 or 4,000 brands all in all when you add it all together. I've watched them, track them, some for 10 years, watching how that brand moves in response to marketing efforts, in response to corporate events that change the dynamic, watching the financial companies after 9/11. I was monitoring MasterCard, Visa, American Express, Discover Card, and I watched exactly how they performed after that and which of them recovered quickly, depending on what they did as brand managers. Making sure that the power of that brand wasn't damaged by the events surrounding them. I have worked with huge companies, done massive research projects, $5 million, like the biggest research project we've ever had for a brand company in this country. And I did that for 4 years looking after Pepsi. All those huge brands companies that I worked with and brand managers didn't feed my soul, didn't give me meaning. The jobs I loved most were working with the smaller companies, where the person who was hiring me felt that brand in his soul or her soul, where that person was really invested, where that brand was part of them. It was like the outfit that they wore or the spirit that was inside them, and it was being translated into a brand. So using my background in astrology, my background in understanding meaning and purpose, I pulled together the ability to look for an entrepreneur at their brand, what that brand is doing and how it can serve you best. So I'm running a free brand health clinic next Monday, well, this Monday, the 18th in Thousand Oaks, where you can come along and find out how a brand is structured. What is the difference between your business, yourself, and your brand? And see exactly how strong your brand is and what you can do about it if it's not exactly what you want. So my time is almost up. Are there any questions? Yes.
Okay. Can you describe what the difference between a brand and a logo is?
Yes. Okay. Yes, lovely. A logo is a demonstration, a mnemonic for your brand. When someone sees your logo, everything that comes into their mind, everything they think about, feel, their gut reaction, and their intent to use or recommend you should be evoked by the picture of that logo. But that logo is not your brand. It is the mark of your brand. When you see a Pepsi or a Coke logo, you think fizz, mouth, yum, yuck, whatever your orientation is. You think if I'd have it if I was desperate. All those thoughts and feelings immediately is the brand. So the brand is the big thing and the logo is the thing that should evoke it, but it's not just your logo. If I say Coke, you think something. So it's one mechanism. Good question. Any others?
Still have time.
Still have time? Any other questions? You all know your branding? Cool.
Question.
Yeah.
You mentioned astrology.
Yes.
How do you use astrology as a tool to help a client with their brand?
Great question. The astrology has enabled me to pull out the fundamental principles that are at back of a character. And that character or personality may be human and may not be. There are fundamental qualities that exist in our mind space. You trust, you have confidence, you feel alive. All those kinds of things are translated into what the planets represent. So I have taken the traditional meanings of the planets, and through a process that has evolved and actually earned me an award as a published author, I have managed to reduce everything to the fundamental quality. So I can use that to help you design the brand that you want, to make sure that your brand is set as a heart brand, if you're servicing from the heart, as a mind brand, if you're going after like a mortgage broker or something, going after the intellectual thing, or as a spirit brand, if you're someone who is helping from the soul of a person and how they get together.
Do we need to prepare anyway for that seminar? What's going to take place?
Bring your business cards. We're going to check your logo out.
Okay.
Thank you. All right.